Hey everyone, Dr.Mungli here. In this particular video, I will be explaining you all about Sitosterolemia. Now, what is Sitosterolemia? Sitosterolemia is an autosomal recessive condition because of a mutation in a gene that is coding for a protein called sterolin. Now, what kind of genes are coding for a protein called sterolin? Sterolin is coded by two genes which are referred as ABCG5 and ABCG8 genes. ABCG5 and ABCG8 genes, they code for sterolin transporter. This sterolin transporter is ATP binding cassette transporter. That is why we refer it as ABCG5 and ABCG8 transporter. Now, where exactly these transporters are present? ABCG5 and ABCG8 transporter, which is together we just refer it as sterolin transporter, it is located in the intestinal epithelial cells and also it is located in the hepatocytes, that's in the intestine and in the liver. Now, what is the job of sterolin? Now, the sterolin, it is helpful in pumping of sterols back into the intestinal lumen so that it will be excreted in the feces, and also the sterolin in the liver, it is going to pump cytosterol, which is a plant sterol, into the biliary canal so that it will get out of the liver into the bile, and then from there it enters the intestine, from there it will get into the feces. So, this is an excretory mechanism of phytosterols or the plant sterol. Most common plant sterol is a sitosterol. This is how we excrete plant sterols out of our body. Now, so in this excretory process, the role of sterolin, which is coded by ABCG5 and ABCG8 genes, is very important. Now, in the first place, how we absorb these plant sterols? Now, the plant sterols which are coming into our body through the diet, especially the oils coming from vegetables, like vegetable oils contain plant sterols, and also the oil coming from nuts and seeds which contains plant sterols. When we eat vegetable oils and eat nuts and seeds, so it also contains plant sterols. So, some of the plant sterols are absorbed along with the cholesterol molecule. Now, we have this efficient mechanism of pumping this plant sterol back into the intestinal lumen, or pumping the plant sterol which are getting into the liver by chylomicron remnants, pumping it back into the biliary canaliculi. There you need a role of sterolin or ABCG5 or G8 transporter. So, with all this pumping mechanism, only less than 5% of plant sterols are absorbed into our body, and they will be found in the blood. So, in cytosterolemia, what happens? There is a mutation in a gene that is coding for ABCG5 and ABCG8 transporter, and that is coding for sterolin. So, when there is a mutation in these two genes, so that means there is a decreased functioning or mutation in sterolin transporter. Because of this, what happens? So, the intestines which are absorbing sterol, plant sterols along with the cholesterol, so that plant sterol, cytosterol, is not pumped back into the lumen. And also the liver, where the plant sterols are eventually getting into the liver, so liver is not pumping these plant sterols into the biliary canaliculi. Overall, plant sterol levels, that is cytosterol levels in the blood, increases. So, blood cytosterol levels will increase, and this cytosterol will become a part of our cell membrane. And also note that ABCG5 and ABCG8 transporters are also involved in pumping of excess cholesterol out of our body into the lumen of the intestine or into the biliary canaliculi. So, in cytosterolemia, because there is a mutation in these two transporters, so that is sterolin transporter, because of mutation in ABCG5 and G8 transporter, that will also lead to accumulation of cholesterol, excess cholesterol in the blood. So in cytosterolemia, there is excess cytosterol in the blood and also there is excess cholesterol in the blood. So what will happen? So this cytosterol and cholesterol will accumulate in various tissues in the endothelium of the blood vessel also, giving rise to accelerated atherosclerosis process. When the atherosclerosis occurs, and that can predispose cytosterolemia patient to going for myocardial infarction or stroke, overall cardiovascular events can occur. You can see cardiovascular incidents in patients with cytosterolemia. And also patients with cytosterolemia will show accumulation of lipids just beneath the skin. Those are called as xanthomas. So the patients with cytosterolemia can show cutaneous xanthoma. These xanthomas can be seen on the elbows, can be seen on the knees, can be seen in the Achilles tendon, or it can be seen on the buttocks. So these are the areas where you see xanthomas. So you see cutaneous xanthomas, you see tendon xanthomas, see accelerated atherosclerosis in cytosterolemia patient. And most importantly, and one of the diagnostic feature here in cytosterolemia is elevated cytosterol in the blood along with the cholesterol, and also patients with cytosterolemia will show hemolytic anemia. So there will be hemolysis, that means red blood cells will break open. Why there will be hemolysis in cytosterolemia, which is one of the distinctive feature of cytosterolemia, and sometimes this will be the only sign of the disorder. Why do you see hemolysis? It is because cytosterol will become part of this red blood cell membrane, and this is an abnormal sterol, and that leads to increased rigidity or the stiffness of the red blood cell membrane, and the red blood cell will break open, giving rise to hemolytic anemia. So that will increase in blood bilirubin levels, giving rise to jaundice. So hemolysis and abnormal shaped red blood cells can be seen, and that is called as stomatocytes. So stomatocytes are seen in cytosterolemia, and also the platelet size will be increased, and also the number of platelets will be decreased. So that will give rise to macrothrombocytopenia. So that is macro means big, thrombocytes means platelets, macrothrombocytopenia. So that is the decrease in the platelets, and whatever the platelets that are there, they are big in size. That is what is macrothrombocytopenia, which is seen in cytosterolemia. Stomatocytes, that is abnormally shaped red blood cells, giving rise to hemolysis and atherosclerosis. So increased cholesterol, increased cytosterol, all of these are the features of cytosterolemia. So this is all about, if you decrease the plant sterols in the diet, so you can significantly decrease some of the signs and symptoms. And also the signs and symptoms will appear in a child whenever plant oils or the food containing oil derived from the plants are introduced. So this is all about cytosterolemia. I hope this video has helped you in understanding cytosterolemia. If you like the video, click the like button there. Or if you have any question, put that question in the comment section below. And also make sure to subscribe this channel so that you get regular updates whenever I make a video. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video.